live bands in the world. They're about to set embark on their national Australian tour, but they've come in a day early to chat to us. Please welcome Mark, Tom and Travis, Blink 182.
One of the greatest live bands in the world. That was a great...
Well, it's true. You guys put on one hell of a show.
That's what we always said. But, you know, not a lot of people believe.
Now, I have been getting it wrong. I've been saying Blink 182, and I got the word that it's Blink 182. Is that correct?
We like them
we
both.
Prefer 182.
So you guys don't care.
And actually, you know what? The first place, other than Southern California, where we started developing fans years and years ago was in Australia, and we always loved it when we came down here because they always said Blink 182, and we thought it was cool. So we always felt like this was like a second home for us. Actually, for real, and I'm not lying.
Now, I didn't realize this before talking to Nancy from The Simpsons. You guys have performed on The Simpsons.
Yeah.
How much fun was that?
I had one word on that. What was your line?
I said, dude, let's trash this place.
Yeah, we had just a couple of words. But you know what, though? When we came, we were just talking about that earlier today. When we came down here, too, when we first started touring Australia, Simpsons was such a big thing. Mm. It was huge down here. And people were asking us what was happening, like, in the next season, because we got it before you guys did. And we would say lies.
So how is it that you get to be part of that? Do you guys offer yourselves up, or does, you know, do they come knocking to you?
They definitely asked us, I think, because we... It's not like we can just ask them to let us on there. That was like a really weird thing that we were able to do that. That was cool.
Yeah, that was cool. That was like total dream come true. I remember the day that our manager called us up. We were on tour in Phoenix in the United States, and our manager called us up and said, The Simpsons called and they want you guys to be on the show. I was like, yeah.
Now, you guys have all recently become fathers too. Congratulations.
We just found out, yeah.
You land back in the country all of a sudden. But are you enjoying fatherhood?
Oh, yeah. It's awesome.
It's the best.
It's really cool. You know, people always tell you, it's going to be so insane. You're going to love it more than anything. But you don't even know until you do it. And it was so easy for us. All we had to do was like 15 seconds of work. And then it was like, done. 9 months later, you have a kid. But it's so cool. It's so cool, too, because you take the focus off yourself, you know, and you get to like... try and raise a beautiful, perfect kid in such a crazy world. It's hard. It's a challenge.
Now, Travis, I think you've got the newest child. Is it hard to embark on a tour on the other side of the world and leave a newborn behind?
Yeah, it's tough. You know, he's 5 months old. You know what I mean? But I got to do, like, this is like my well-being. This is what makes me happy, you know? And when we tour the States, he'll come with me, you know? But, yeah, it's hard. You know, all you can do is be positive, you know? Go out and play music.
Now, Tom, I think it's you that has the daughter, Ava?
Yes, I do. Yeah. I got to keep it away from these, like, pervert boys.
I was going to say, the other, Mark and Travis have got two boys. Whatever happens if one day they come knocking at the door with a bunch of flowers.
Oh, man, he's hung, too.
It's going to be interesting. You know what's going to happen? And I don't even want to, like, predict it, but I think my daughter's going to be safe, and they're going to turn gay.
Those two end up together. I wouldn't mind seeing that. You know, it bring the band together nicely, I think. So has it changed your writing style, your performing style, the fact that you're proud fathers now?
I don't think it's affected the band so much as it's affected us drastically as individuals, but as far as, like, the music and the band, I think that not really so much.
It makes you want to work harder, or, like, you enjoy everything more, you know? But we're not, like, writing songs about changing diapers.
We actually did that. They were adult diapers, though. We sang a song about that about 10 years ago, about diapers for the senior citizens. You know? Our kids, it didn't really affect our songwriting, you know, but like they said, you know, it affects us individually, but when we wrote this last record, we were still the same band as we always were, but it's a much darker and much deeper and much more thought-out record than we've ever done, but we're still the same guys, and we still had... you know, adult films running the whole time in the room, you know, and doing what we always do and joking around, and we're still the same people. The great thing about being in a band is you have such an absence of responsibility, but then when you become a father, you do have such a massive responsibility, but I think we're all going to be cool dads. I'm excited.
Well, it's good because you've got the responsibility off stage, and then when you're on stage, you can let it all out.
That's great. It is true, and it actually really is like that, though, kind of, you know, you can do whatever you want. But and then you go home and you do have to, you know, be a dad and have something, like you said, you know, be a different person then too, I guess.
Well, the boys are about to close the show for us, so I'll let you head over to the band area. But please thank the boys from Blink 182. Thank you, guys. Thank you. See you in a sec. Self-titled album. Here they are, Blink 182, 182. I'm Rove McManus. Happy birthday, Miss Sally Love for me.